More than a year ago, I made a video showing how to enable light control from a Beoremote One through a Bang Olufsen Mozart-based product. For some people, this seemed like a large task since not all felt very confident in setting up an entire Home Assistant instance from the bottom, which is completely understandable. However, since then, a few things have improved to make this process a lot easier for beginners. Late last year, Home Assistant introduced the Home Assistant Green Box, which you can buy for around 110 euros. It comes pre-installed with Home Assistant, so it's really just a matter of connecting Ethernet and power to get going. Secondly, Bang & Olufsen Mozart platform-based products now have an official Home Assistant integration, which means you don't need to install the custom integration to control lights from your remote. In this video, I'll show you how to set up a brand new instance of Home Assistant, how to add a Bang & Olufsen speaker and a light system to it, and lastly, how to control lights from Beoremote One using a so-called blueprint. We should be up and running in a matter of minutes, so let's go. I've already connected my Home Assistant machine to my router and powered it on. The first time you boot up a brand new Home Assistant instance, it needs to initialize, which can take up to 20 minutes. Mine has already been left on for 30 minutes, so let's try to access it in my browser. To access it, I can either use an IP scanner to find the IP address, or I can simply enter homeassistant.local and remember to add the port 8123 at the end. This brings me to this screen. Now it's simply a matter of following the wizard to set up username and so on. So I'll click create my smart home. I'll enter my name and a password. Create account. Here I can set up my location so I can see the local weather or when the sun goes up and down. So I'll just enter store, this, next. You can enable analytics if you want to give feedback to the community. I'll just click next here. And now it has already found compatible devices. And you can see that we have Bang & Olufsen speaker, and we have some Google Cast things and Philips Hue. So let's try to press finish here. Now that the first time setup is completed, we are presented with the default dashboard where we can see our current entities. As you can see, we cannot see our Hue system here, and we can see the kitchen speaker, but it's the Cast entity. So to set up the Bang & Olufsen and Philips Hue, we need to go to settings and devices and services. And here we can see the things that it has found that are not set up yet. So let's start with the speaker. Simply press configure. And we confirm that it appears on level with this serial number. Press submit. And we can add it to an area if we want to. And I'll add it to the kitchen in this case. Press finish. So that's done. Next we set up the Hue. And here I press configure, and then it asks us to go down and press the button of the Hue bridge. So I'll just do that. So wait a second.
A few moments later.
Once that is done, simply press the submit button. And here it will show the rooms you've set up in your Philips Hue bridge. So press finish now. Now that the entities are connected to Home Assistant, all we need to do is to install the blueprint. If you don't know what a blueprint is, it is basically a predefined automation where you simply have to input the different variables or products that matches your setup. To find the blueprint, let's open a new tab in the browser and go to cklit.dk, which is where I store my Bang & Olufsen related blueprints for Home Assistant, which also includes shade control, among other things. At the very top, you can see a button called Control Lights using Beoremote One for Mozart products. Click that. Then select Import Blueprint to my Home Assistant. And then here, ensure that this address corresponds to your Home Assistant. So I'll press Save, press Open Link, and then I'm redirected to my Home Assistant instance. Press the Preview button and select Import Blueprint. Now we have a blueprint. The last thing we need to do now is to convert that into an automation. So I'll click the automation tab here. Click create automation. And now I'll simply select Beoremote One light control for Mozart. Now we need to select the speaker our Beoremote One is connected to. Press the device dropdown and select yours. In this case, a Beoresonic level. Below that, select the main light group you want to control. This can also be a single bulb. I'll press choose entity and select lamp. The next two fields here are optional and can be left empty. It simply allows for basic control of other groups or bulbs using the color buttons on the remote. All operation is explained in the text below each field. Once the mandatory fields are filled out, simply press save. Give it a name. Now we are ready to test. Take your remote, press list, navigate down to light, and try to press 9. Your light should now turn to full brightness. Press 0 to turn off the light, or use the arrow up and down to adjust brightness in steps. That was pretty easy, right? Of course, this is just a single use case, and Home Assistant is extremely powerful and can do much more than this. But I wanted to show Bang & Olufsen users how easy it is to get started, and hopefully I succeeded. Thanks for watching.